वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12 सब्जेक्ट इकोनॉमिक्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू रीड चैप्टर नंबर 11, दैट इज फॉरेन एक्सचेंज, एंड दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 3 फॉर दिस चैप्टर। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स। द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट वी विल डिस्कस इज मैनेज फ्लोटिंग। सेकेंड टॉपिक, वाई इज फॉरेन एक्सचेंज डिमांडेड। ओके, थर्ड टॉपिक इज सोर्सेज ऑफ फॉरेन एक्सचेंज, दैट मीन्स फ्रॉम वेयर डू वी गेट फॉरेन एक्सचेंज, एंड फोर्थ वन फॉरेन एक्सचेंज मार्केट। ओके, व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय फॉरेन एक्सचेंज मार्केट। नाउ सी, व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय मैनेज्ड फ्लोटिंग। सी, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज डर्टी फ्लोटिंग। व्हाट हैपेंस इन दिस, विद द एंड ऑफ ब्रेटन वुड सिस्टम which we discussed in our last lecture. Okay, many countries have started adopting the method of managed floating. Now, what does this method means? It means that even when exchange rate is determined by the forces of supply and demand, okay, means in the economy, the foreign exchange rate is demanded by supply and demand at time, RBI, that is the central bank, intervenes to manage the exchange rate so that it does not slip out of the desired limits. Okay, so basically managed floating refers to a system in which foreign exchange rate is determined by the market forces and central bank influences the foreign exchange rate through intervention in the foreign exchange market. Now, the question arises, how does the central government controls the exchange rate? Okay, see. First situation is when exchange rate needs to be reduced. Now, when exchange rate needs to be reduced, what does it mean that the central bank needs to reduce the value of, say, let us take US dollar. Okay, now what will the central bank do? RBI or central bank will release the supply of dollar in foreign exchange market. Okay, now due to this release of supply of dollar in the foreign exchange market, what will happen? The price of US dollar will reduce. And if price of US dollar will reduce, that means the value of domestic currency will appreciate. Okay, the value of, let us take rupees, will increase. Okay, this is how the central bank reduces the exchange rate in the foreign exchange market. Now, when exchange rate needs to be raised, now what will the central bank do? It will increase the demand of US dollar. Now, how can it increase the demand? By its own purchase. Okay, the central bank will purchase the foreign currency itself and the demand for US dollar will increase. Now, if there will be increase in demand for US dollar, that means there will be rise in price of US dollar. If US dollar price will increase, that means the price for the domestic currency, that is rupees, it will decrease. Okay, so there would be depreciation of domestic currency. So this is how central bank, or we can say RBI, controls the foreign exchange rate. Okay, now the next question is, why is foreign exchange demanded? Okay, why do we need foreign exchange or foreign currency? The first point is, we need foreign currency for repayment of international loans. Now, what do we mean by this? That foreign currency is required for repaying the international loans. Okay, when the less developed countries like India take loans from abroad or from rest of the world, then we need to repay that loan. And we need foreign currency for repaying the international loans because we have to make the payment in foreign currency. Okay. Next one is investment in rest of the world. Now, what does this mean? That it is a very important business activity that we invest in rest of the world. That means in other countries. Okay, suppose we have to invest in America. Now, for making investment in America, we need US dollars. Okay, so for investing in rest of the world, we need foreign currency. Okay, next one is imports. See, we import goods such as TVs, phones, okay, we import such goods and we take many services of banking and insurance from the rest of the world, okay, or we can say from abroad or other countries. Now, when we take such goods, when we import such goods, we require foreign exchange for payments, okay, for payments of import, we need foreign exchange. Clear? Next one is direct purchases abroad. Now, what does this mean? This means that when people from our country visit other countries, okay, suppose you have visited some other country for tourism. Now, there, if you will purchase something, okay, that means you need foreign currency. So, when we go to abroad for studies or for job or for any other purpose, we need foreign currency. Okay, so it creates demand for foreign currency. Next one is grants and donations. Now, what does grants and donations mean? As a part of the world, we have to contribute whenever there is need in any of the country. So, for making grants and donations to any other country, we need foreign currency. Next is payment of incomes. Now, demand for foreign exchange or foreign currency in our economy arises for the payment of factor incomes like rent, interest or wages, okay, which are to be paid in abroad. So, for paying incomes in abroad, we need foreign currency. Okay. Next one is speculative trading. Okay, we know that there are speculative business activities. Okay, so when we do such activities, speculative business, we need foreign currency. Okay, for speculation. Now, the next thing is sources of foreign exchange. Now, earlier we were reading about why do we need foreign exchange or foreign currency. Now, we will read that from where do we get foreign exchange or foreign currency. The first source of foreign exchange is exports. As we do imports, okay, and for imports, we need foreign exchange. Similarly, the other countries, purchases goods from our country. And at that time, for exports, they need foreign exchange and therefore our country receives foreign exchange. Okay? See, suppose India has exported goods and services to US. Okay? That means US would pay dollars to India. Okay? Now, next way is investment from rest of the world. Okay? When the other countries invest in our countries, okay, when other countries invest in our countries, from there we get foreign exchange. Okay? Suppose India is a country, okay, India is an underdeveloped country and US is a developed country. So, when US makes investment in India, through investment we get foreign exchange. Next one is direct purchase by rest of the world. Now, as a tourist, we go outside the country. Similarly, people from rest of the world visit our country, okay, and they make direct purchase from our country. So, from direct purchase by rest of the world, we get foreign exchange. Next one is loans from rest of the world. Loans means borrowings. When India or our country borrows money in the form of loans from rest of the world, we get that money in the form of foreign currency. Next one is grants and donations. Okay, whenever there is any tragedy or famine in our country, that means the rest of the world give grants and donations to our country. Okay, basically rich countries give grants and donations to poor countries. So through grants and donations, we get foreign exchange. Next one is income. See, income is also an important source of foreign exchange. It is like a factor income. See, when people of our country work in other countries, okay, at that time they get income, and they get income in the form of other currency, foreign currency. So this is the source of foreign exchange. Next one is remittances by non-residents. See, remittances by NRIs, okay, the person who works in foreign countries, okay, they get allowances, okay, and they send those allowances to India for their family. Okay, those allowances are in the form of foreign currency. So this is also a source of foreign exchange. Now the next topic is foreign exchange market. What do we mean by foreign exchange market? It is the market in which foreign currencies are bought and sold. Okay, it is a market where foreign currencies are bought and sold. Who are the buyers and sellers? See, buyers and sellers include individuals, firms, foreign exchange brokers, commercial banks and central banks. Okay, these are the buyers and sellers. Now you need to understand that like any other market, it is a system. It is not a place. Foreign exchange market is not a place. It is a system. Okay, and transactions in this market are not confined to only one country. There are many countries who are involved. Okay, there are many countries and many currencies involved in foreign exchange market. Now it comes to what are the functions of foreign exchange market. The first function is transfer function. Now what do we mean by transfer function? It says that foreign exchange market transfers the purchasing power between the countries, okay, involved in the transactions. Suppose India and US are two countries who are involved in the transaction. So either it will transfer the function from India to US or from US to India. Okay, it works as transferring the purchasing power from one country to other country. Okay, and it is done through the instruments like bills of foreign exchange. Bills of foreign exchange. Now, the next function is credit function. Now, it provides credit for the trade, foreign trade. Okay, foreign exchange market gives us credit for doing foreign trade. Okay, now it can be done through bills of exchange, okay, which have maturity periods of 3 months. Okay, next function is hedging function. Now, what does this hedging function mean? See, when exporters and importers enter into an agreement to sell and buy goods on hedging on some future date, okay, at current prices, an exchange rate is called hedging. Okay, when exporters and importers enter into an agreement to sell and buy goods on future date. Okay, when exporters and importers enter into an agreement to sell and buy goods on future date at current price and exchange rate, this is known as hedging function. Okay, so basically what happened, the purpose of hedging is to avoid losses that might be caused due to exchange rate variations in future. So that's why we enter into an agreement that we will buy goods on future date but at current prices and current exchange rate. Okay, so that we can avoid the loss which we may face due to variation in exchange rate. So this is hedging function. Now it comes to kinds of foreign exchange market. Okay, there are two kinds of foreign exchange market. First one is spot market, second one is forward market. See, what do we mean by spot market? Spot market refers to the market in which receipts and payments are made immediately. Okay, they are not left for some future. Okay, they are made immediately. Okay, it deals in spot transactions. That means it is daily in nature. It is daily in nature. And rate of exchange that prevails in spot market is spot exchange rate. Okay, so whatever rate of exchange prevails in spot market, that rate of exchange is known as spot exchange rate. So what do we mean by spot market? In spot market, receipts and payments are made immediately. Okay, it deals in spot transactions. That means it is daily in nature, and the exchange rate which prevails in such market is spot exchange rate. Now it comes to forward market. What do we mean by forward market? See, in such markets, sale and purchase of foreign currencies is settled on specified future date. Okay, at a rate agreed upon today, or we can say at current price. Okay, at current price or current exchange rate. Okay, as it was done in hedging function. Now, the exchange rate that prevails in such market is known as forward exchange rate. Okay, now the question arises, why such contract is entered? It can have two reasons. First one, to minimize risk, okay, which may occur due to changes in variations in exchange rate. And second one, to make profits. Okay, so that's all for today's video. Now your homework is you have to revise complete chapter 11, that is foreign exchange from macroeconomics, and you have to do given assignment. Okay.